So, happy Tuesday. I wasn't planning on making a video for this week because I was at MBLGTACC, Mumble Tech, in Madison, Wisconsin, which is basically a giant conference for queer people, or if you don't like the word queer, any other part of the alphabet that goes under that umbrella. But we needed to fill in. So here I am making a video, because like I was actually looking forward to this topic. I was gonna have a friend of mine join me, because he can kind of speak to this experience. He has a young daughter that he actually transitioned after she was born, but I don't have him here, so I'll have to speak from what I would like. Future, I suppose. So, question number one. As children are learning, girls do this and boys do that. If it were your kid, how would you approach dressing as yourself? Well, because of the way I identify as male. I don't particularly like the term man and don't identify as a man. I don't think that when I have children, there will be a problem with my children understanding that I'm a boy or that I dress like a boy. I think they will have more trouble understanding why I'm a boy that has a vagina. I think that will be the context from which they will try to understand it, because my outside appearance is so comfortable and natural to me that I don't think that will be the question. I think the question would be why the things that most people argue otherwise, like, well, you have a vagina, so it has to be that way, but it seems like I'm a boy, so why do I have a vagina, I think will be the way at least younger kids would get it, at least if they were your own. If they're coming from outside the situation, I don't think that's how they react, but I don't know, that seems like what would happen. At first I took this question another way. I thought it was like how to raise kids, and I kind of want to touch on that too in case that is a topic. I don't really have a chance to ask anyone. I thought maybe it was asking how I would approach dressing, having my kids dress if they wanted to dress quote unquote deviantly, which whatever that means. When I was growing up, my parents just let us dress however the hell we wanted. My brother ran around my clothes. I ran around his clothes. So, and it seemed to make me feel a lot more comfortable for most of my life. And my brother turned out not trans, even though he'd wore my dresses. So, I don't think it was a harmful experience for either of us, because it made me more comfortable as a person, and it didn't affect my brother being a cis person at all. He's completely comfortable being a biological male that identifies as a male and all that stuff that comes with it. So, I say, you know, let them do what they want, but if they want to do something that's kind of different, you know, once they get to school years, explain that it might come with some repercussions and see how they have that dialogue with you. And I guess that, you know, applies to dressing yourself, too. If they ask you why you're doing it, or why, you just need to explain to them, you know, like, that it means more to you than what the other people will say. And, you know, they may not understand it when they're little, but they will understand it more and more as they grow up. And that's just how it works with pretty much everything. Kids will just understand things more and more as they grow older. As I look back on things that my parents have told me from the time when I was really little, I look back and I see what they were really trying to tell me. Sorry, really tired. So, you know, I think it's pretty much going to be the same with any other topic, trans or not. So, and then the second question is, what if my child told someone outside of the home that I'm trans? I don't know. I don't know that it would be that big of a deal, especially with what's gone on recently in my life with, like, my roommate being so drunk that she doesn't even remember telling a bunch of people that I'm trans, and, it really didn't have that, it didn't have an adverse effect on my relationship with these people at all. And with that kind of as my starting place for life, you know, these people are worth my time to be around because they are kind individuals. If my kid tells someone outside the house that I'm trans that doesn't know, then, you know, I guess it might be more complicated in the case of their teachers, school board, PTA, that kind of thing. I don't even know what kind of navigating that's going to take, because I don't know how much the world's going to have changed between now and the time that I actually can adopt children, because I have to get a PhD first. Sorry. So, that, I think, is one of those things that you just have to take it as it comes, but, the friends of the kids, my friends, they're just not worth having, and I don't know if I want my kid to have the values of a family that, is going to be really closed-minded. I mean, I'm sure my kid's going to learn a lot of interesting and weird things, but I'm going to try to instill my kid with the best of values, basically. I'm talking like I'm only going to have one, but, you know, I don't know how many I'm going to adopt, but whatever. So, I hope you enjoyed this slapdash presentation from the lab I work in the psychology building of my school, because this is where I found out I needed to make a video for today, so that's what I did. And I will see you next week, hopefully a little better prepared.